best lyrics always. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you.
So I had to walk away from the mic, y'all. But I felt the Holy Ghost right here, y'all.
I don't care what the devil is saying, but he's gonna be with you right here. He never lets us down. Happy Wednesday, happy Wednesday, happy Wednesday. God bless you. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Just love God. Blessings. May the good Lord bless you wherever you're tuning in from, wherever you're joining in from. God bless you. If you want to go ahead and tell me your locations where you're tuning in from today, if you want to tell me what's happening to you, if you want to tell me your time zone, remember it is our midweek service. Distance is not a barrier in the realm of the spirit. Make sure you are connecting somebody. Make sure you're writing down somebody's name. Tell the Lord to locate you. Tell the Lord to heal you. Somebody go ahead and decree and declare, my healing Wednesday. Somebody begin to say, my healing Wednesday, my healing Wednesday, my healing Wednesday, my healing Wednesday. I want you to type my healing Wednesday. I want you to type my healing Wednesday. If you're here, type my healing Wednesday. You can stand in for your parents. You can stand in gap for anybody. Distance is not a barrier in the realm of the spirit. I connect you from Liberia. I connect you from Washington, D.C. I connect you from Maryland. I connect you from Denver. I connect you from Nigeria. I connect you from Ghana. I connect you from wherever you are in the ends of the world. Just make sure you're sharing the broadcast. You need to do me a favor by sharing for the Lord. You are not sharing for me, but you are sharing for God. And as you share for the Lord, may the Lord share in every difficulties. Whatever it is that brought you into God's presence today, as you share for the Lord, may the Lord share in those problems for you. I just want to let you know something, that your life is never going to remain the same. Your life is never going to remain the same. Your life is never going to remain the same. I don't know what happened yesterday. I don't know how long you've been praying. I don't know how long you've waited on God. But I just want to let you know something, that your life is never going to remain the same. As you tune in, make sure you're sharing with somebody. Make sure you're inviting somebody. Make sure you're calling in someone. God has been wonderful. God has been precious. Please make sure that you are reacting to the broadcast and know that God is able to do just that He says He will do. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God, cause He won't give up on you. He's able. Ha! Somebody, can you say God is able? Can I hear you say He's able? I want you to just type He's able. My God, this is my healing Wednesday. Somebody begin to decree and declare it's your healing Wednesday, and nothing is gonna take it away. As you decree, I seal it for you. It's my healing Wednesday. You decree, I seal for you. You decree, I seal for you. You decree, I seal for you. My God, my God, my God. As you decree, I seal for you. As you decree, I seal for you. As you decree, I seal for you. Something is happening right here. I'm actually using my cellular data. I'm actually using my cellular data from Africa. I am finished to play this music that I'm playing, but that's totally fine. Anything for God. So please make sure that you're sharing. God bless you. God bless you. Let's get 200 going for the Lord. Let me see your locations where you are watching me from. God bless you, Michael. God bless you, AG. God bless you, Walala. God bless you, Eberry. God bless you, Doris. God bless you, Trinity. God bless you, Teresa. God bless you. Make sure that you are sharing. God bless you. You need to share until I call your name. That means your comment doesn't show. I need you to understand something with Facebook these days. Facebook is really fast with the comments, and we thank God that the comments and the reaction is showing on the phone. So I don't need to use two phones. I can see all of your comments on one phone, and I see 146 people right now. I bless every hand that is sharing the broadcast. I bless every hand that is hosting a watch party. I bless every hand that is inviting somebody. I bless every hand that believes that God is able. I bless you wherever you're tuning in from, that the God of awesome wonders is not going to stop you from receiving in this service. The God of awesome wonders is not going to delay your blessings. The God of awesome wonders is not going to omit your name. The God of awesome wonders is going to put you in his plan. The God of awesome wonders is going to write your name on a testimony. The God of awesome wonders is going to select you for a miracle. The God of awesome wonders is going to select you for a marital settlement. The God of awesome wonders is going to select you for a breakthrough. The God of awesome wonders is going to select you for a promotion. The God of awesome wonders is going to select you for that miracle that is about to take place. Somebody, I see that there is a breakthrough that is coming for you, but each time this breakthrough is about to land, the enemies do not allow this breakthrough to land. I see a breakthrough that was meant to come for you, but each time this breakthrough wants to land, the enemies are not allowing this breakthrough to land. I don't know who you are and you are listening to me, and you are associated with somebody with the name Lawrence. I don't know who you are listening to me right now, and you are associated with somebody with the name Lawrence. You are associated with the name Lawrence. You are associated with somebody that has the name Lawrence. Or you are ye makala branda ya likababa sekete makushata libra kayanda. Let me ask you something. Maybe you are here and your name is Lawrence, or you know somebody that you know with the name Lawrence. You know somebody with the name Lawrence. I want you to just write Lawrence and put in Psalm 1. After 15 minutes, remove it. I cancel every insanity in the life of Lawrence. I cancel every spirit of insanity in the life of Lawrence. I cancel every spirit of insanity in the life of Lawrence. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are a lady. I see you this morning. You ate something that is like Irish potato. I don't know if it's Irish, but it is like Irish potato. It is not yam. It is not sweet yam. It is in that form. That is what you ate this morning. You took it with cheese. After you ate that, you have been having stomach ache in your tummy. You have been having very strong cramps. You have been having very strong cramps. I don't know where you bought what you ate, but it was poison. It was poison. As I am talking to you right now, I release the hand of the Lord to locate you in the name of Jesus. I release the hand of the Lord to locate you in the name of Jesus. I release the hand of the Lord to locate you in the name of Jesus. Makala branda ya likababa sekete. Somebody say my healing Wednesday. 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 I want to let you know something. I want to let you understand something. If I see your name, your file opens and I'm going to prophesy. Ashanti. 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 Where is your dad? Ashanti Bwanche. Where is your father? Ashanti Bwanche. Where is your father? Ashanti Bwanche. Where is your father? Where is your father? Where is your father? What is happening to your father? Where is your father? Because I am seeing your father so sad in the realm of the prophetic. Ashanti Bantue, I see your father so sad in the realm of the spirit. I see your father putting down his face like this, and he's standing and looking at you. Where is your father? Is your father even alive? Makala Brandaya. Holy Spirit, I thank you. Somebody begin to worship. Begin to worship. Begin to worship. Welcome the Holy Spirit. Reference the Holy Spirit. Connect somebody that is sick. Anybody that you know that is sick. Says woman of God, a lot has been going on. Okay. So I am seeing in the realm of the prophetic, I see your father standing and looking at you. I see your father putting down his face and is looking at you. I see your father putting down his face and is looking at you. That is why I am asking you if he is even alive. Because I cannot understand why he should be putting down his face and looking at you. He should be looking at you up. He should be looking at you directly, but this way is doing like this. Makala branda yali kababa sekete makushata libra kayanda. So many files in the service. Somebody says, I have a nephew with the name Lawrence. Do what I'm telling you to do. I am not telling you. I said, somebody, you are here, you are watching me.
Either your name is Lawrence or you have somebody with the name Lawrence. When I give prophecy in my services, it's direct. I don't give you prophecy that you are not here. I give you prophecy concerning what I am seeing. Just write the name Lawrence and place it in Psalm 1. After 15 minutes, take away the name. Every spirit of insanity in the life of Lawrence is canceled. You should be glad that you are in this service, because in the realm of the spirit, I see Lawrence running mad. In the realm of the spirit, I saw Lawrence going mad. I saw Lawrence going mad. And it's like I was coming, and I don't know where I was coming from, but it's like I was coming from a truck. Then I saw Lawrence. I saw the name Lawrence, and I saw him standing with some nylon and those things in his body. And you can see that this is a fresh madness. That is why I said, if you are here and your name is Lawrence, or you have somebody with the name Lawrence, just write his name, put it in Psalm 1. After 15 minutes in the service, take out the name. Every spirit of insanity in the life of Lawrence is canceled. Makala Brandayaya. If I be a woman of God, you are going to see the sign in Lawrence before the Lord takes it away. Rika Baba Sekete Makushatali Bragayanda. Make sure you're sharing the broadcast, and make sure you're hosting a watch party. Make sure you're sharing a broadcast, and make sure you are hosting a watch party. Somebody says, Mommy, you have not hosted a watch party. Thank you so much. God bless you. Let me quickly go and do that. Make sure you are commenting. Make sure you are commenting. Make sure you are commenting. I am going to speak, and I am going to be prophesying, and I am going to do deliverance, even if it's my communion service. By the special grace of God, I had already mentioned that I am not going to be doing a service without deliverance. From now till the Lord asks me to stop, I am going to be doing deliverances in all of my service, except you are not encouraging me. But if you encourage me, trust me, my services are going to be prophecies, deliverance, until the Lord asks me to stop, or until we get to the relationship week. I just want to appreciate God for every one of you, wherever. Christiana Ayidoha, God bless you. Christiana, it is your first time of watching me, or you have been watching me before now. Christiana, I am seeing you with a garment of praise. I don't know if it is your first time of watching me, Christiana, but I see a new garment on you. Let me know. This garment that I'm seeing in the realm of the spirit is either for two things. Either it is your first time of being in this broadcast, or God is about to put a garment of praise on you, Christiana. But I see a new garment on you. As soon as I saw your name, I saw a new garment. Christiana, I saw a new garment. Are you a married woman, or are you a single lady? Christiana, are you a married woman, or are you a single lady? Do you want me to crown you with this garment, or do you want me to leave it? Do you want me to seal this garment, or do you want me to leave it? I see a new garment. I see a new garment. I see a new garment. It is either it is your first time on my broadcast, or God is about to honor you. Are you a married woman, or are you a single girl? If you're a single girl, I want you to believe God for marital settlement, because I see the garment so clear in the realm of the prophetic. In the realm of the prophetic, I see this garment so clear. Christiana, 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 Christiana. Makala Brandaya Lika Baba Sekete. I see a garment, a fresh garment, a new garment. Let me know if it is your first time of being on this broadcast, or you are a single lady. If you want me to release this garment, I will release this garment. And as I release this garment, I am not going to allow this garment to pass this year. Makala Brandaya. I will not let this garment to pass this year. I will not let this garment of praise to pass you by this year. You will return with a testimony. She said, I am single. Makala Brandaya. So you just came to this broadcast and you received marital settlement. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, by the divine mandate and the divine mantle, I use this as a point of contact, and I wear over Christiana's life. This is the garment of celebration. This is a marital garment. Father, I release in the name of God the Father. I release in the name of God the Son, and I release in the name of God the Holy Spirit, a husband that is after God's heart. No delay, no excuses. Makala Brandaya Lika Baba Sekete. I release your right husband in the name of Jesus. I release your right husband in the name of God the Father. I release your right husband in the name of God the Son. And I am hearing the number 8. I hear the number 8 in the realm of the spirit. Christiana, what do you know with the number 8? It is done. Christiana, what do you know with the number 8? I use Christiana as a point of contact to every single person on this broadcast that is believing God for marital settlement. And I am still hearing the Holy Spirit says that this is the first time for this Christiana. Christiana, is it true? Is it your first time on this broadcast? The Holy Spirit says to me, it is her first time, but I want to give her a foundation because she doesn't have a foundation. Christiana, I hear that it is your first time on the broadcast. Is it true? Makala Brandaya, I hear it is her first time. Please, somebody, if you see a comment, put it in for me. Mommy, if you know you speak and change my life, you've been speaking and my life has been changing. Glory to God. Can some Christiana, please, can somebody see Christiana's comment and put it for me? I am hearing in the realm of the spirit that Christiana, it is her first time. Despite the garment that has been released for her, that it is her first time to watch this broadcast. Christiana, are you here? Has she locked out or she's here? I hear it is her first time on this broadcast. The Lord says she doesn't have a foundation, so I want to give her a foundation. The Lord says I want to give her a foundation because there's been so many disappointments and heartbreak for her. She has had so many disappointments. Can she talk to me? 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 It is her first time of being on this broadcast. He says, the Lord says it is her first time of being on this broadcast. Today is her first day. And then the Lord gave her marital settlement. Holy Spirit, I thank you. Holy Spirit, I worship you. Yes, mommy, today is my first time. Somebody celebrate grace. Celebrate grace. Hey, my Lord. She said, today is my first time. She said it's her first time. God bless you. Other people are seeing the comment. Let me tell you something. I don't know where you go, but you see this woman of God. I tell you the prophetic in total. If I want to prophesy, I prophesy. I don't prophesy. If I want to tell you the mind of God, I tell you the mind of God. I don't need to know you. I don't know her from nowhere. Today is her first day. I was saying that there are two things involved in the realm of the spirit. It is either it is her first time of coming or God wants to give her marital settlement. And the two things that I said are the two things that has happened. Strictly prophecy. Makala branda yaya. Celebrate grace. It is not me, but the grace of God. I don't guess. I don't need to bring you and start asking you questions. I said, if you are not a married woman, you are a single woman. This is marriage coming for you. I said, if you are a single lady, that means you have just received marriage like that. Makala branda yalika baba segete. Who is speaking in your life? What is the coverage? Now, let me tell you something before I continue. There is a bad news. The Bible says we should rejoice with they that are rejoicing, and we should mourn with they that are mourning. Today I mourn my daughter in the Lord because she decided to take her own life. Today I mourn my daughter in the Lord because she decided to give way to the devil. Today I mourn my daughter in the Lord because she disconnected from grace. Let me tell you something, child of God. Can somebody help me to type? When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. Today, may the soul of Sister Bethy rest in the bosom of the Most High God. A lot of you know Sister Bethy very well. Please make sure you're sharing this broadcast for me. A lot of you know my daughter, Sister Bethy. The Lord brought her into my life in 2018. The Lord brought Sister Bethy. Akuntebe. I don't want to miss her name. The Lord brought her into my life. Akinkube. May her perfect soul rest in peace. We have lost her. How many of you remember during the midnight prayer when I was shouting that there is a grave? I said, I see a grave. I see death. How many of you remember when I was sending God to the ICU unit in Maryland? How many of you remember when I was shouting, release and say, mercy of the Lord, mercy of the Lord, mercy of the Lord. When you disconnect from grace, you stand to be disgraced. When you disconnect from grace, your enemies will laugh at you. When you disconnect from grace, your life can never remain the same. The Lord brought her into my life in 2018. And somebody challenge her physically and said she was going to die. Everyone that said she was going to die, they all died for her. I told her, I said, Betty, no matter what happens in your life, make sure that you seed your life. Make sure that you see your life. Make sure that you see your life. My daughter was a consistent and faithful tither and seed in her life from 2018 until April 2020. In fact, in the year 2020, I never saw her tithe. I never saw her seed. One day I called her, I said, what is happening? You guys remember the last broadcast I brought her on the screen? The last broadcast I brought her on the screen, like one time like that. And I told her, I said, they have given you a job to go in and save people with COVID-19. As you are going to work with those people, make sure that you pay your tithe. Make sure that you seal your life so that the Lord will keep you. In the family where she was, all of the people died. New Jersey, she came. I told her that she is not going to die. She survived death 2018, 2019. Last year, I still told her in Maryland that somebody wants to take her life, but I revised the grave to that person. How many of you were there in Maryland? After the program in Maryland, 3 days after, her mother died. 2 weeks after, the auntie died. All the people that wanted her to die, they died for her. But I don't know what's happened. Let me tell you something, child of God. The devil is very intelligent. The devil knows that when you are connected to grace, he cannot take your life away. The devil knows that when you are connected to grace, he cannot take your life. So what the devil does is to disconnect you from the grace that he knows is going to speak for you. The devil wants to take you away from that grace so that once he takes you from the grace, then they can succeed in doing that. I want to believe something, that the devil went and played tricks on our mind and say, ha, 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 you have been sowing seed since 2018. Nothing has happened to you. Forget it. Nothing is going to ever happen. You're already solid. You're already secure. Nothing is going to happen. Since January 2020, she has never sowed for her life. I told her to be sowing a seed of life, because the person that is working on her behalf morning and night is going to the shrine pouring libation. They say she must die. I said it openly on this broadcast. Since January, Betty did not do anything. I brought her when she was going in for the COVID-19 job. I said, make sure that you see your life, because it is a battle. And when I came on the broadcast during the 40 days of midnight prayer, I said, I see grave. I see death. I even called one of my daughter's name. Some people are saying, mommy, I was there. I covered grave in Maryland. I brought her out from the grave. I laid on my daughter. I laid on her and I took away death. I said, let them come and kill me. I kept her on the floor and came on top of her. I transferred my life, because I have a covenant with preservation with the Lord. I transferred my own life into her. I said, let them come and kill me. 3 days after the Maryland program, she testified, the mother died. After the mother, 2 weeks, she testified, the auntie died. But you disconnected from grace. When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. When you connect from the real grace and go to the fake grace, your eyes will open. I don't know where she was, but she was not connected to me. Even on my birthday, when the Lord says people should celebrate me so that they can be celebrated, she did not celebrate me. On my birthday, when the whole world was celebrating me, she did not celebrate me. I went through her post. I went through her world. Even when she was sick, the people that knew that she was sick, they did not tell me. I don't need nobody to tell me. And when she died, Mahawa called me on the phone. She wanted to tell me that Betty is dead. I just replied her. I said, you want to tell me that Betty is dead? I already know. I told her, I already know. She was shocked. Let me tell you, if you're thinking that you're doing me a favor, you are not doing me a favor. You are only helping me when you take away yourself, because one prayer point is gone. You are doing me a favor when you disconnect yourself, because you cannot disconnect yourself and I keep on praying for you. Why? You cannot be wherever you are and I keep on praying for you. Why? It's impossible. And then the daughter messaged me, mommy, I want to inform you that my mother is late. And I replied her. I said, when your mother was sick, did you tell me? She could not open her mouth to speak right from as I'm talking to you right here. Some of you, you were buying my water for me to drink. Some of you, you were buying my milk for me to drink. Some of you, you were doing something in one way or the other to connect to grace. And all of a sudden, you stopped. All of you disconnected yourself. As you disconnected yourself, I want you to know that I have also disconnected you. There was a woman, $5, I am not going to mention her name, but when she watches this video, she will cry for her life. There was a woman, $5, drinking water is $5. She was buying my water for me to drink for her children. Her children were doing very well in school, but today, she cannot tell me that those children are not struggling because I see that those children are struggling, but there is nothing I can do. If your mother disconnects you, why will I connect you? She's the one that connected her children on her own. I didn't tell her, connect your children. She said, Mommy, for as long as you live, for as long as you live, I will be doing what? I will be giving drinking water on behalf of my children. And you broke that covenant. When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. It pains me that she set herself to this death. When I was seeing the grave, when I was, I called my daughter, I said, where is Miriam? Where is Miriam? Where is Miriam? Where is Miriam? Who remembers that prophecy? They called Miriam. They said, Miriam, Mommy is looking for you. Mommy is looking for you. Miriam came on the live broadcast. When Miriam came on the live broadcast, Miriam could not comment. I said, people of God, Miriam is here, but I am still seeing the grave. It might be for somebody else. Somebody say, Father, Lord, have mercy. I say, Miriam is here, but the grave is still standing. I am still seeing a grave. I am still seeing a coffin. I'm still seeing a coffin. I saw a coffin, clay. When Miriam came on the broadcast, I said, Miriam is here, but I still see the grave. I still see it. I still see it. And people were like, ah, Mommy. People went, Father, have mercy, Father, have mercy, Father, have mercy. Go back to the video so that you will know that there are people that God will show things to before they happen. And I was praying and sending God to the ICU every day on that midnight. Every day on that midnight. How many of you remember? I was sending God to ICU in Maryland. And in the night, okay, it's a long time I blocked somebody, but I just did. In the night, I was lying down in my room when the Holy Spirit came to me. And the Holy Spirit says to me, he says, why are you bothered about people that have long disconnected themselves from you? Why are you worried? I said, really? He says, okay, you are asking me really. My God, the broadcast is going to cut off on us. Please make sure that you're sharing and you are engaging. Make sure you're sharing and you are engaging. The Holy Spirit says, why are you worried about people that have long disconnected themselves from you? Do you know that I was shocked to go on my daughter's page? After the whole, you know, sometimes you doubt the Holy Spirit because of the love and the trust you have for people. Immediately, I went onto my daughter's page. I went to her Facebook. I began to scroll down the Facebook. And I saw that aside of her, not even doing this thing for me, that the last time she connected on this broadcast was in May 17 was the last time she connected. Oh, that Father Lord, the storm is over and all of that, she was not there. She wasn't there. So she got the job. She got engaged in her job. She enjoyed the job. She made so much money that she forgot where the helper came from. When you reject and you neglect grace, you will be disgraced. Now, when you die, there is no job in heaven. Now, when you die, there is no job in hellfire. So, people of God, don't be so hungry for money that you forget where your place of help came from. So hungry that you forget where your helper came from. 2018, a woman fought a battle for you. A battle of life and death. I fought for this woman. I saved her. Even the husband was telling me, Mommy, you have, if not you, my wife would have long gone. People that knew her, she was not able to use her leg. She wasn't able to use her leg. Where are the people in Maryland program, USA? used me, but you neglected me, and you think that my God is sleeping. No, I feel so sorry for those of you. I am laughing at you the way I am laughing right now. You see this Heaven Chapel, I will not hide your death. I am one woman of God that will not hide your death. I am not like your pastors who will hide your death. When you die, they will not announce. Me, in Heaven Chapel, we celebrate you and we mourn you. When you die in this Heaven Chapel, we will do what? We will mourn you. You have a testimony in this Heaven Chapel, we will celebrate you. I have been telling you. I say, if you die, I will mourn you. When you celebrate, I will celebrate you. In this Heaven Chapel, I am not going to hide. And I'm not going to hide death. So this is what happens. When you reject grace, you stand to be disgraced. Somebody that took away, everybody in your family died. Your brothers died. Your sisters died. You are the only one that survived. But because you now had a permanent job, where you went in to work for people that you were taking care, you were living there 24 hours. You were living there 24 hours with the people with COVID. Not that it was even when you were not having money. The devil will play tricks with you. That is why I say it is when money comes that you know the true color of people. It is not everybody saying, I love you, I love you, I love you. Mommy, I don't have a job. Somebody says, Mommy, I was actually there. And it's absolutely right. People that were there in Maryland program, they will tell you, I kept this woman on the floor. I laid them on top of her. She could not walk. But before the end of the program, she was walking with her two legs. She was running around the hall with me. I told her, follow me. Walk, walk. She was walking. I'm telling you about raw grace. If I had one person that was honest and truthful to God, I would follow that woman of God with the depth of my heart. She stopped. No tithe, no offering, no mommy, how are you doing? No mommy, things are not going well. I am the one that prayed for you to be chosen because she said you need a job. That they are putting people at your workplace to work. You need to go and live there so that they will pay you from morning till night. You want to go and live there. I said, write the name of the company for me. She wrote it and I released it and they called her. She came back on this broadcast. She testified. She was on camera. Everybody saw it. I said, make sure you pay your tithe. She went there. She forgot. And that's how the devil did what? They took her away. Even on my birthday, she did not say, Mommy, happy birthday to you. She did not. Even on my birthday, even when the Lord says, when you people that celebrate you, they will be celebrated. Their life will be preserved. She did not. What I did to her is what I don't know. But this is how the devil wanted it. That's what the devil wanted. And she, I'm sure by now she's lying in the mortuary and she's remembering all the words that I told her. I'm sure now she's lying in the mortuary and she wish that she can come back and say, hey, woman of God, look at what you said has happened. I said, the day you stop to covenant your life, that is the day the enemies will defeat you. Because the one that is going to the shrine for you is not resting. All your brothers died. All your sisters died. Your mother died. You were the only survivor from 2018. You were doing it in 2020. You said, no, I cannot continue to give this woman of God money. You think you're doing me a favor? No. When you go away, let me tell you the truth. Let me tell you the truth that a lot of you don't know. If you are a sower in my ministry, you have given me work. Because there is no how you sow that I don't say, may God bless your seed. Some of you, I type prayer for you. Some of you, I bless your seed. Some of you, I just type something for you for that month. I preserve you for that month. The moment you disconnect from me, my dear, yesterday my daughter was telling me, Mommy, go and sleep. Go and sleep. Because I am moving from the house where I am. I have taken my bed. I use the biggest bed, the king size bed. That's what I sleep. My friend that lives in the house with me, he has what? He has a king size bed. So he works in the night. So we take chances. We take time right now to sleep. So I sleep at night. He sleeps in the morning. Now I am awake. He will sleep when he finishes work. But I think he's working, although I've not seen him. I was praying and he was go and sleep. whether your prayer has finished. Me, I am still praying. Your own is after midnight, you are gone. Me, I'm still praying. Your own is after a long time. Chi boy blank. I am seeing problem coming for you in the realm of the spirit. Chi boy blank. I saw you and I saw like an anchor by your name. Chi boy blank. I saw you and I saw an anchor in your hand. There is a problem that is coming for you, Chi boy blank. I saw your name and I saw something like an anchor on your hand. I saw you and I saw something like an anchor on your hand. Are you having problem with anybody, Chi boy blank? Do you have issue with anybody right now? Do you have any pending problem? Because I see an anchor by your hand, Chi boy blank. Please make sure you are hosting a watch party. I want to see 300 souls for the Lord. Make sure you get your Holy Communion ready. I just want you to understand that you're not doing nobody a favor when you do these things. You're not doing nobody a favor when you do this thing. I prayed for a lady. She did the same thing to me. I prayed for her. You guys remember that lady? $500. $500,000. She did not pay tithe. She came and gave God $25. Some of you, you are so wicked in the heart. It is easy for you to ask for prayer. But when God does that thing for you, you refuse to acknowledge God. You will die before your time. You cannot cheat man and you remain. Do you know what God said to me? When God called me, I asked God a question. And the question I asked God was, how is it going to happen? Where am I going to go from here? What is going to happen to my own life when I give you my own life? What will happen to my own life? These are the questions that I asked God. I did not just come to God blindly. I asked God a question because when I was working in my job, all of you knew that I was having a very good and beautiful job. I have never worked below $50. Below, the first day, the first job I had in Canada when I came was $70. I have never worked below $70. So if I am telling you that my tithe for 2 weeks is $3,000, how much do I earn? I have never done menial jobs. I work in my field of profession. I am a medical practitioner. So if I tell you that my tithe for 2 weeks was $3,000, in a month I pay $6,000 tithe in my church, how much do you think I owe? How much do you think I worth? I built for my parents. I bought a car for my parents. Before I came to ministry, I'm not saying now that I am in ministry. God allowed me to put all these things in place because he knew that a time like this will come. So I will now come and sit down, pray for you. God will bless you with a job. I'm the one praying the prayer. You carry my blessings and you go and give your pastors because they are rubbing bleaching cream and I am not rubbing bleaching cream. Or you carry my blessings, you go and give your big maid because they have a big church and I don't have a church. You will suffer. Don't try it. If you have been trying to repent, you will suffer like a thief. Don't rob Paul to pay Peter. God is against it. God is against it. Chi boy, I want you to open to the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 3. Read it. When you read it, you fetch water in a glass. You place on it. You read it 3 times. Place a glass of water on it. When you finish, take that water, pour it in a bucket, go and shower. And then say, any battle, let me issue. Anybody that wants me to be anchored over what I don't know, Father Lord, vindicate me. It is done. It is done. It is not by force for you to connect. But those who are connecting, they are seeing results. Those who are connecting, they are seeing results. Yes, now you go and give the money to your pastors because they are rubbing bleaching cream, right? They need money to maintain their skin. Me, I don't rub bleaching cream, so I don't need money. You will go and give them because they have big churches they need to maintain. But me, I am paying rent in a small place. Yes, I don't have. But you come here, I do deliverance for you free. Very soon. Very soon. Very soon. Write it down. Very soon. A time will come that you will say, Mommy, I want to pay for counseling. My ushers will say, no, Mom, you cannot talk to Mommy. A time will come, you will say, just tell Mommy that I'm paying $10,000. They will say, if you want to pay, pay. If you don't want to pay, leave it. You cannot have access to Mommy. A time is coming. A time is coming where you would say, Chai, those days, this woman of God, I wish I knew. You wish. People in the mortuary are wishing like you. If you treat me, my father will treat you. If you bless me, my father will bless you. If you curse me, my father will curse you. That is why I tell people, I say, don't question my grace. I came from far away to this place. I wasn't hungry. I was working when I was in ministry. I had jobs. I do live broadcasts from my job. Ask people who have been following me from 2017. Not because I couldn't find a job, I said that God called me. It was in this my job, after Maryland program, that God took my job. After Maryland program, on my birthday in the month of, in the year 2019, my birthday was supposed to be 29 June. The Lord took my job like on the 10th of June. The broadcast is there. I did a video that day. It's there. Last year, God took my job. A well-paid job. And they paid me off. They laid me off. I worked on Monday, worked on Tuesday. Wednesday, I was laid off. After I came from Maryland, where I told the Lord, take my life. Do whatever pleases you. Take my job. Take my marriage. Take my everything. How many of you remember? I was on the floor singing, telling God to take me. Do whatever he likes with me. And God started by taking my job. When he took away my job, I asked him, I said, what's going to happen to me? Some of you, you died untimely death. And then somebody calls me. You are calling me to inform me that Betty died. When Betty was alive, did you sow a seed of life for her? You that said you loved her. You that knew that she was sick. Did you sow a seed of life for her? Don't give me bad news. Betty has long disconnected from me before her death. Even on my birthday, she did not celebrate me. Somebody says my internet is down. Mawa said, no, it was New Jersey program. I told the Lord, take my job. Do whatever pleases you with it. Some of you, you were buying milk for me. Some of you, you were buying water. You disconnected. Let me tell you what I did. When I was drinking your milk, every day when I poured the milk, I said, God, any man or woman that has ever drank milk and is fighting this, my daughter, may they die as I drink this milk into my tummy. Some of you, you were giving me water. You disconnected yourself. Me too, I disconnected you. I want you to be aware so that you will not say you did not know. I want you to know that if you were disconnected from me, that I had also disconnected from you. The Bible says two cannot work together except they be of agreement. We cannot work together. I know my children and my children know me. The Bible says I know my sheep and my sheep knows me. There is no point for you to do what? To pretend. I know when you disconnect. I know when you connect. There is no two way for you to pretend. And I am a woman of God that is very frank. I tell you the truth the way it is. You may not like me today, but when you finish going round, they take from you, take from you, take from you. You will come to love me. You will come to say she is the best. So you don't need to love me. But what I am bringing your way today is that what? If you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. When you disconnect from grace, you will be disgraced. Probably you disconnected your husband. Probably you disconnected your children. Probably you disconnected yourself. Let me tell you something. There is my daughter here. She feels that because she gives money to my ministry, she feels that because she gives money to my ministry, she can be calling me anyhow. I told her, come back on the broadcast. If you cannot save God, forget about it. Forget about it. I told her, every service, she's the one that sows seed. She pays donations. She does this, she does that. But she does not come on the broadcast. I specifically sent her a message. I said, you know that my love, the way to my heart is by loving the Lord. The way to my heart is by loving the Lord. If you like, give me $1,000 every day. You don't come here to save God with me. You're wasting your time. The way to my heart is through the Lord. You must save God. I must take you to God. Because there are days when I will not be there. I need you to pray to God. I need you to look up to God. There are days where I will not be available. I need you to do what? Ekoso desire. I don't know who is this person that I'm seeing behind you, but I see a lady with a chocolate skin. I see a lady with a chocolate skin, and this lady is always complaining of headache. Ekosa, I see a lady behind you, and she's always complaining of headache, 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 headache. Right now, as I am talking to you, as I saw your name, this lady appeared. She's chocolate skin. She's not short. She's an average height, but she always complains of headache. If you are ever going to see her, I want you to just use your left hand, and put on her forehead and say, I take away every pain. When you remove the pain, put it to the wall. Put it to the ground, anywhere it is done. Ekosa, that is for you. I see your name, I prophesy. Make sure that you're sharing the broadcast. I don't care whether, if you like, give me car. If you like, buy me Lamborghini. If you like, buy me Ferrari. If you cannot save God, you're wasting your time. You can never win my love. You will never win my love. I told her, I said, come on the broadcast and pray and save God. Stop sending money into my ministry. Don't bribe me. Come here and save God. This is where the grace is. Do you know what happens to you? Anytime you come on the broadcast, the witch confess that anytime you come on the broadcast, that something is taken out of you. Everything that they put in you, that when you come on the broadcast, everything is gone. She said, whether you locate them or you don't locate them, so long as they are on the broadcast, everything is taken away. Everything is taken away. Everything is taken away. We are going to remain 1 minute silent. It is 11:54 right now. At exactly 11:55, we will pray for the soul of our departed sister to rest in peace. May our perfect soul rest in peace. May the Lord accept her in Jesus' mighty name. We love you, and you will be greatly missed by us. God bless you. Rest in peace, Betty Akum Kube. Akum Kube. May the Lord accept your soul in Jesus' name. Amen. It's sad to see you go, but you know, when you disconnect, then you will be disgraced and you will be defeated. Let this be a learning. Let this be a warning. Let this also be an eye-opener to those of us. From 2018, I kept her under the bosom of the Lord. I kept her steadily. I followed her up. From 2018, everybody died. But the day she stopped to sow, because she thought she was doing me a favor, or maybe that's how the devil wanted it. The devil says, no, we must disconnect you to take you. Because so long as you are connected to this woman of God, we will never be able to kill this woman. We need to take her away from this woman of God so that we can strike. We can strike. I was sending the Lord to the ICU. I wasn't even aware that she was not connecting. And the Holy Spirit told me, he said, on your birthday, did she celebrate you? Some people have long disconnected from you, and you are still there. You are still there. You had a full-time job. You went in to secure people's life. Full-time, not that you are not working, for you to say, I don't have money. You were working. Full time, you were living there Monday to night. How many of you remember when I called her on the broadcast? She was wearing a mask, right? She was wearing a mask. She was wearing a mask because that's where she lives. She was, you can imagine working for 24 hours, but you refuse to give that little. You refuse to give 10% to God. Why do people love money so much? Why do people love money? Money is the root of all evil. God gave you a 24-hour job. You asked me to pray for it. I prayed for it and it came. And I called you. I said, you see that God answered. You say, yes, mommy, yes, mommy. I said, don't forget your tithe. Ah, mommy, no, mommy, don't want my mommy. Trust me, mommy, trust me, mommy, trust me. That was what she said. But she never did it. She never did it. And that's how they succeeded. That's how she succeeded. Don't be so hungry for money than your life. Because the person that is going to the shrine is not going to meet the abelisk for free. How about me that is sitting down praying for you? Do you not have a love in your heart that this woman of God should drink water? That this woman of God should drink milk? That this woman of God praying for me deserves everything? Makala Brandaya, Margaret Anthony, God bless you. Annie, I am seeing applications like this. Annie, I see applications like this. Annie love, I see applications like this. And I see somebody standing with the law. You know the lawyers week. I see a man standing with some application and is wearing the lawyer's wig. What problem? What do you know? What do you know about this, Anna? I see files. I see applications. I see documents in front of you. Annie love, listen to me. I am prophesying now. Annie love, I am seeing somebody in the realm of the spirit with files like this. And the persons wear a wig of lawyers. That cap that the lawyers wear, that is what I see this person wearing. What are you doing? What are you applying for? Do you have a court case or are you applying for documents? Do you have a court case? Do you have immigration issues? What are you doing? Because I see file and I see the lawyer's hat, the lawyer's wig, that wig that the lawyer wear. I see somebody in the realm of the spirit carrying files. I see your name on these files and I see the wig of a lawyer. Do you have a court case or are you applying for something? Makala branda yali kababa sekete makusha tali brakayanda. Ida maseke rama. I am waiting for you. Be very quick. I see Anna love. I see application, Annie love. I see application in the realm of the spirit. And I see your name with it. And I see the wig of a lawyer. I don't know if it is a court case or you are applying for an application. But I need to know because I see application in the realm of the spirit. Ida Maseke. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Where is she? If somebody sees Annie Love comment, please let me know. Sometimes she says she has a court case. Ida Maseke. Annie Love, do you know me before? She says she has a court case. Annie Love, do you know me before? Have you told me anything concerning yourself before? Ah, Holy Spirit, I reverence you. Somebody says, celebrate the grace. Annie Love, do you know me before? Did you tell me anything before? I said, I see application. I see a wig of a lawyer. You know the lawyer's wig. I see that on the person's head. And I see a name. As soon as I saw Annie Love here, I saw applications. I saw the wig of a lawyer and I saw this. And I'm asking you, do you know me before? Did you tell me anything before? I don't prophesy. And I'm not going to ask you what is happening. I'm going to prophesy. I'm going to tell you what I am seeing. It is called grace. This is what I was born to do. I wasted my years in the medical school. Hey! I wasted my years in the medical school. Ah! Holy Spirit, help me. I don't know her before. I said, put your name, put your comment. Somebody say, Holy Spirit, locate me. This morning I woke up and the Lord says to me, he said, you need to tell your people. This morning the Lord said to me, you need to tell your people that their name should not be omitted. He says that there is a blessing that is coming, but some people's name will be omitted. What is omission? They will take out some people's name. Some people's name will be omitted. He says from the list of celebration. May my name not be omitted from the list of promotion. May my name not be omitted for marital settlement. May my name not be omitted on the healing list. May my name not be omitted in the list of prosperity. Somebody begin to give the Lord 400 souls today. If you're not hosting a watch party, begin to host a watch party. If you're not doing anything, begin to do something for the Lord. We are going to quickly go into deliverance. As we deliver, we prophesy. Annie, I am waiting for you because you have not answered my question. Annie, love, I am asking you, do you know me before? Did you tell me anything? Did you tell me, woman of God, I have a court case? Woman of God, I am calling you to pray for me over my court issue. Did you tell me anything concerning this, your prophecy now? Last year, one of my daughter in the U.S. went and fought somebody. In the school, she slapped somebody, you can imagine. Because of what? Hot tempered. She slapped the person. Make sure you're sharing the broadcast and you're hosting a watch party. If you're not ready for this broadcast, I will just bless the Holy Communion and we go. But I feel that I should just do deliverance and pray for some people before we go into the communion. But if you're not happy about it, I can let you go. She went and slapped somebody in the school. And they wanted to expel her. They sued her. They took her to court. I stood in this broadcast. Counsel the case. And she went and she was victorious. She could not even believe it. She was shouting, "Mommy, do you know that as you counsel the case, they counsel the case?" Grace is available. The reason that you cannot see my grace is because you have cheated me. The reason you cannot see my grace is because you call me mother, but you don't behave with me as a mother. The reason my grace cannot work for you is because you have refused to see where the rain fell on you. Some of you, you came, you took from me, you ran away. Some of you, you came, you stole like a thief, you left. That is why it will not work for you again, because you cannot continue to steal. When you say that somebody is your mother, you need to treat them like your mother. When you say somebody is your father, you need to treat them like your father. When you say, "I am surrendering over the grace of your life," when you eat, think about me. When you buy clothes for yourself, think about me. When you feed your children, think about me. Know that this is where, even when I'm sleeping, my woman of God is praying for me. I am not like them, oh, who will take your money and then I will go and buy bleaching cream. Maybe that is why you're not giving me, because you know that I cannot buy bleaching cream. Maybe that is why you're not giving me, because you feel like I don't have no bleaching cream to rub. But I will make you understand something. Holy Spirit, thank you. Holy Spirit, thank you. The last time we contributed for a phone, we did not buy that phone, right? Because somebody gave me a phone and two of my daughters bought the MacBook for us. So we didn't buy a phone. Right now, the Holy Spirit just reminded me, I am seeing you in the realm of the Spirit. You have been gossiping. The Holy Spirit just showed me you now. If you continue to gossip like that, I will call your name. I will bring you to do deliverance for you. Then I will disgrace you. You have been gossiping. You are not a part of the people who contributed. Why? What is your problem? You have been gossiping. You did not contribute for this phone, but you have been gossiping. I see you gossiping in the realm of the Spirit. Please, if you are the one, repent. Otherwise, I will disgrace you. If you don't repent, I will disgrace you. If you don't repent, I will disgrace you. If you are the one, do what? Stop it. You did not contribute for this phone. And I have sat under the prophetic chair. I sat under the prophetic chair and I announced that the money that you were supposed to buy that phone, that God has blessed me with a phone, and somebody gave me a phone. Somebody gave me a brand new phone. Then two of my daughters bought the MacBook. So we don't need that money. And I am not going to use that money. We are going to use that money to buy a church van. We are going to buy a car for the church. We are going to buy a mini van for the church. It might not be a bus, because the money is not enough for us to get a bus. But we are going to buy something for the church. Maybe it's a Sienna, Toyota Sienna. Maybe it's a small Honda. Any of those kind of small space bus, seven-seater. Anything seven-seater. That is what we are going to use the money to buy, so that we can transport people. Being that the money was meant for church, I wanted to use the money for an outreach program. But so far, a lot of people have been contributing for our outreach program. As a matter of fact, my daughter from Florida, in person of Maggie Singley, she gave the church a computer, she gave the church a TV, she gave the church a projector, she gave the church flower vases, and she has shipped these things from Florida to New Jersey. Single-handedly, somebody did that for God. She bought t-shirts for the ministry. She bought non-perishable items for the poor. And she has shipped them from Florida to New Jersey. And from New Jersey, it will be coming to Nigeria. This is what we do in this ministry. We don't copy. From 20,000, 2007 till now, we have been doing outreach program. That is why the Lord gave me Heaven Chapel. I added foundation, because I have been running a foundation right from 2007. I've been running a foundation. When I was a copper, I did an outreach for the less privileged. I opened boreholes, I opened latrine, I fed the poor, I go for medical treatment with other doctors and treat the community back in Cross River. So please, we don't want to use that money for outreach, because a lot of people single-handedly have already bought things. So if you are here and you want to support Heaven Chapel with the t-shirt, with non-perishable item, please make sure that you contact us. The ushers are there. You can message them. Whatsoever you want to send for the less privileged in Nigeria, you can ship them to New Jersey. And from New Jersey, it will be going to Africa. And if you are here and you want to contribute for the bus, you want to contribute for the minivan for the church, please make sure that you send your donations. We are going to buy that bus ASAP. Like, and I'm not saying next month. I am saying ASAP. ASAP is maybe right now, maybe tomorrow, maybe next tomorrow. But we are going to buy it before I leave Canada. And I'm also planning a vacation to the mountain. And I'm also planning to go on the mountain. If God has blessed you to bless me, if you want to pay for my hotel, if you want to pay for my food, if you want to pay for the ticket, whatever support you want to give, it is now for you to give. By next month, we should be planning that trip. And tickets are going higher by the day. So if you want to be a part of that blessing, support by your tickets, by your donation, whatsoever you want to do, you will do it. Don't come and say, woman of God, pray for me on that mountain, if you did not donate to it, because the Lord will slap your mouth. Some of you, all you need to do is just for you to do what? Receive and never give. Don't be a receiver. Be a giver. That is where the blessing comes from. Learn to give than to receive. That is where you get blessed. Learn to sow on the right foundation. That is how you get blessed. So please, if all these three announcements that I am saying comes to you, please make sure that you respond accordingly. I was just about to pray for somebody, and the Holy Spirit told me that. So may the Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless those that will obey in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless those giving in the name of Jesus. Okay, so please make sure you get your water ready. Make sure you get your water ready. Ushers, begin to type me. Michael, Anita, we are going to check up on you after your deliverance. Michael, Anita, we are going to check up on you after your deliverance. Now, let me tell you something. If you're thinking that it is because of you that the church will not go on, you are a liar. There are these two girls that felt that they were God in this ministry. There are two girls that were very close to me. They felt that they were God. Today, they are ashamed, because they thought that when they go, the ministry will not run. Why? Because they were the ones bringing idea. They were the ones bringing contribution. They were the ones donating every day. So they felt that without them, the church will not run. If you think that, the church will not go on because of you. Any day that you want to disgrace me, that's the day God opens door. Eh? You are not even away. When I go for the mountain program and come back, I will tell you people how I got to the mountain. how much ticket I bought for the mountain. I will let you people understand that there are people that are crazy for God. You see me? I can sell my house for God. I can sell my car for God. But I will not allow you to ridicule my God. It's impossible. Me. I will never allow you to ridicule God. So if you think that the work of God will suffer because of you, I'll prove you wrong. Because you're not the one that called. The one that called is able to provide. And he will give to those whom he knows that he will, they will give back to him. This is my prayer. This is my prayer. Father, please, anybody that you know that is a thief, is a stealer of your blessing, don't bring them to Heaven Chapel. The few people that you're going to bless in Heaven Chapel, bless them to be a blessing back to you. So these are the kind of people I am praying God for. Father, anybody that you know will be of a blessing to you, bless them to bless you back. Don't even waste your time with people. Anybody that you know is going to be a channel of blessing to you, Lord, in this Heaven Chapel, bless them. This is my prayer. I don't pray for everybody. Anybody that is going to be a channel of blessing in Heaven Chapel, may the Lord bless you. There is no point. I pray for somebody, $500,000. The person did not return with 10%. So if I pray for all these kind of people, then Heaven Chapel will fall. So I rather waste my time on those who will lift up this Heaven Chapel. Let God bless them so that they can bless God back. This is the kind of prayer you should pray. Don't waste your time. It is not everybody that must like you. It is not all churches that you must go. It is not everywhere that you must celebrate. No. Just the few that will remember God. Let God bless them so that they can remember them. I told you people something. I gave you a prayer point. I said, if you are honest from your heart, tell the Lord, Father, bless me so I can bless your first lady. And the prayer will work for you. Tell God, Father, bless me so that I can bless your first lady. Somebody prayed that prayer last week, communion service, and the Lord healed her instantly. Somebody prayed that prayer, and the Lord healed her instantly. Make sure that you're sharing the broadcast. Michael, where are you? Michael, Anita, where are you? I need to quickly check up on you before I enter the next broadcast. And what's her name? Ogechi, get ready for me. After Michael, I will be calling you, Ogechi. After Michael, I will be calling you, Ogechi. After Michael, I will be calling you. Just pray. Tell the Lord, if you say that this is your first lady, bless me to bless her. See how God will answer you. God loves me. He said, I did not call you to suffer. I asked the Lord, who is going to pay my bill? The day I asked the Lord, who will pay my bill? He was laughing. Me, I want God to bless my sons. Me, I am interested in God blessing my sons. You know why? You know why? Because when God blesses my sons, I will not suffer. You women, you are too jealous. You women, you're too jealous. Very soon you'll be saying, this mommy self. If God blesses my son, they will bless me without. In fact, when your wife is saying, why are you blessing this woman of God? They will tell you that if you really want to stay in this marriage, do what? Close your mouth like this. Because when you talk against this woman of God and the finances stop coming, you will go. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Make sure that you're sharing the broadcast. Steven, you're just joining the broadcast. Make sure that you call me after the broadcast. Let me tell you what God has been doing. Let me tell you what God has been doing. My son sent a testimony I have not posted yet. Steven, he was robbed. How are you, my son? How are you? Your network is very bad. Your network is bad. This network is very bad. This network is very bad, but it looks really good today, though. It looks really good today. Michael, can you change your location? Can you try to change your location where you are? Okay, Chi, are you on this broadcast? Please make sure that you're sharing the broadcast and you're hosting a watch party. To everyone blessing me, may the Lord bless you. I see some blessings coming in into the phone. May the Lord bless you. You would go here, you will go there, you will run around like that. Run, you don't know what you want. If you're not even faithful to yourself, how do you want God to be faithful to you? Do you understand? You're not even faithful to your own self. How do you want God to be faithful to you? Sometimes, I just don't understand. Somebody say, Father, please, let my testimony not delay any longer. Father, let my testimony not delay any longer. As you're tuning in, please make sure you're sharing the broadcast. I don't see you commenting. I told you to tell the Lord, Father, don't pass me by this Wednesday. Holy Spirit, locate my file. Holy Spirit, open my file. I don't see you. I don't see you commenting. That is why your files are not being opened. When I see you commenting, I speak into your life. I need to see your comment to speak into your life. And I'm not seeing your comment. That is why I cannot speak. That is why I cannot speak, because the comments are not coming. So you need to keep commenting and commenting for me to see. I told you how Facebook works these days. Facebook is very fast these days. They don't even give time for you to read the comments. They don't give time for you to read the comments. It comes like that. It goes like that. Okay, so I am going to try the second person. I've been trying. Network is bad. I'm going to try the second person. I want to do deliverance. So please make sure that you are engaging the broadcast for us to have a good network. Make sure you're sharing. Make sure you're hosting a watch party. Make sure you're sending to your friends on Instagram and Messenger everywhere, so that we can have a good network. We can have a good network. I'm trying my best, but the calls are not that clear. Trying my best, but the calls are not that clear. I'm calling the second person now. Ogechi Ochaga. I'm calling you right now. Ogechi. I'm calling Ogechi right now. So make sure, please get your Holy Communion ready. I am not going to be blessing much water today for myself. I'm just going to bless like 3 bottles, because I already have a lot and I'm moving. I don't want to move with it. I just want to finish my water. Ogechi is not picking. Please get your Holy Communion ready. Okay, so please get your water ready. Get your water ready. Let's quickly bless the Holy Communion so we can have time for a divine encounter, and then we can continue with the prophecies. God bless us. God bless us. God bless us. Okay, so today we have a word from the book of Ezra. We have a word from the Lord from the book of Ezra. You people saw when I opened it, right? You people saw when I just opened this, right? Ezra. 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 Ezra chapter 2, verses 42. Ezra 2, 42. Ezra 2, 42. The Bible says, the gatekeeper of the temple, the descendant of Shalom, Atta, Talmon, Akum, Atita, and Shaba, the temple servant. And then on my right hand says, Ezra chapter 4, verses 1. When the enemies of Judah and Benjamin heard that exiles were building a temple for the Lord, the God, for the Lord, the God of Israel, they came to Jerubbabel. They came to Jerubbabel and to the heads of the families and said, let us help you build, because like we seek God, we have been sacrificing for him since the time till now. So since the time of Esarhaddon, king of Israel, who brought us here. This is the word of the Lord for us in the communion service today. I don't know who it is that God wants to build a temple for. I don't know who it is that God wants to change his or her story. I don't know who it is that has been in a particular situation for so long. I don't know who it is that has been crying to the Holy Spirit, please need you to have your way in my life. I don't know who it is that the Lord needed to do something, but the enemies did not allow it to happen. Like it was said in the book of Ezra chapter 4. The people went to the king and said, let us help you to build. Today as you are here, the Holy Spirit is going to help you to achieve. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to be established. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to be settled. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to be married. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to be fruitful. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to be to erase that stagnation. The Holy Spirit is going to help you to raise the standard. Probably there is a coverage that is not allowing the standard of the Lord, because the Bible makes me to understand that when the Spirit of the Lord is upon us, then the Lord will raise the standard. That standard has not been risen in your life. But today in the book of Ezra chapter 4 from verses 1 to 3, the people went to help other people to build the temple. They went to help them to finish the work. Just like what it was done, they went, they said, when the enemies of Judah and Benjamin age, they excel of the building of the temple of the Lord. Today, your enemies are going to hear that the Holy Spirit is about to do something. When the enemies of Benjamin and Judas age, I don't know who your enemies are, but I know that the angels of the Lord have already sent a message to them and says, Today, in the Adienaja, I am going to do something new in his life. The enemies of the Holy Spirit have already sent the message to your enemies and said, today in the life of Patrick, I am going to do a brand new thing. The Holy Spirit has already sent a message to your enemies and said, you see this day, in the life of Albert, everything is coming to a stop. You see this day, I am speaking for Angela. That whatsoever hold on, you are holding on to Angela's prosperity. Wilma's breakthrough. You are holding on to Eunice's marital settlement. You are holding on to Wilson's breakthrough. You are holding on to Blessing's upliftment. You are holding on to Trinity's financial breakthrough. You are holding on to Martina's healing. You are going to let it go. The Holy Spirit has already sent a message and say, you see, Tina, you must let this one be. You must let this one be. You must let this one be. Just like the message was sent for Judas and for Benjamin. Their enemies heard it. They heard it. They said, wow, what a message. They must let go. We must let go. Otherwise, something is going to happen. We must answer. Otherwise, we will be disgraced. We must answer. Otherwise, the wrath of the Lord is going to fall upon us. Today, in this meeting, I release a message to your enemies. I said, today, in this message, I release. Today, in this meeting, I release a message to your enemies. I send a message to the camp of the enemies. And I say, hear me, you Jerusalem. Hear me, you Zerubbabel. Hear me, you Zerubbabel. That is what the Bible is saying. They came to Zerubbabel and to the head of the families and says, let us help you build, because like you seek your God, we have been sacrificing to him since. The enemies are going to say, you know what? I am letting this person go. I am not fighting this battle again. I am tired. I am answering up. An end is coming. Today, in this service, every mountain that has stood in your life, every Jerubbabel in your marriage, every Jerubbabel in your family, every Jerubbabel in your generation, every Jerubbabel in your promotion, every Jerubbabel over your healing. Today I disconnect them. Today I disconnect them. In the name of Jesus. You Jerubbabel and the heads of the families. Every head of the family. Every altar. Every shrine. every principalities, every darkness, any Jerubbabel that has stood like a mountain in your life, tonight I came to irradiate them. As you go to bed tonight, as you sleep in the day, as you awake in the morning, as you sleep in a week, as you sleep in a month, every Jerubbabel, may they fall down and die. May they be broken. May they be scattered. May they be destroyed. May they be disconnected. In the name of Jesus. Somebody, you could be asking, what is Jerubbabel? They are the ones that offered. They said, let me help you to build. It is not Benjamin or Judah that called them. Benjamin did not request for their help. Judah did not call for their attention. They are the ones that went to them and said, let me help you and build, because as you have been building, we have also been sacrificing. So now we are going to come together and we are going to do what? We are going to build. I don't know how long you have been barren for. I don't know how long you have been single for. I don't know how long you have been crying for. I don't know how long you have been in that sickness. But today I came to tell you something. Every Jerubbabel in your life, it is disconnected. Every Jerubbabel in your life, it is broken. Every Jerubbabel in your life, they die right now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Every Jerubbabel that has stood in that job, every Jerubbabel in your document, every Jerubbabel over that court case, every Jerubbabel over your finances, every Jerubbabel over your every breakthrough, every Jerubbabel over your fruitfulness, every Jerubbabel over your wombs, I say today, in this midday hour, may they be broken in the name of Jesus. In this midday hour, may they be scattered in the name of Jesus. Every Jerubbabel that is standing and saying you can never be delivered, and saying you can never be freer, and saying you can never be liberated, and saying you can never come out of it. Today, I came with an angel. I came with a sword today. I came with fire today. I came with arrow today. I came with sword today to destroy the wings of the enemies. Every Jerubbabel, I say, give way in the name of Jesus. Every Jerubbabel, I say, give way in the name of Jesus. Every Jerubbabel, an end comes to your activities right now in the name of Jesus. Every activities of the enemies today marks the end of their oppression. The ones that were operating in your marriage, the ones that were operating from your lineage, the ones that were operating from your foundation, the ones that were plotting from your that project, every abandoned project that was destroyed by the power of any Jerubbabel, today by the power of the Holy Ghost, I speak into that situation. I said, I command you to arise and shine. I command you to arise and walk. I command you to get your documents. I command you to be maritally settled. I command that court case to be over. I command healing upon your spirit. I command healing upon your soul. I command healing upon your waters. I command healing upon your clothing. I command healing upon your food. I command healing on your beds. And command healing in your works. Whatsoever thou touch it, your life shall never remain the same. Your life shall never remain the same. Your life shall never remain the same. The same way that depression came over the children of Israel, the same way they were able to cross the Red Sea, the same way Anna was able to conceive a child, the same way that Esther found honor in the sight of the king, the same way Haman was disgraced because he thought that Mordecai was going to be put down for him to be elevated. But Haman was disgraced when Mordecai was elevated. May that same God do it for you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord send your enemies to sleep and may they never wake up. May the Lord announce your enemy's failure and announce your success. Once he put them down, may the lifting of the Holy Spirit fall upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, Quickly get your communion. Quickly get your communion. This is the word of the Lord, and we are grateful. Thanks be to God over his word. And I know that he will do that which he has said he will do. In the mighty name of Jesus, I have my water ready right now on the scripture. If you look at that, you will see what I'm doing. You see my water right there. You see my water right there. Sometimes you don't really need to see mine, but you just need to connect yours. You just need to connect yours. You just need to connect yours. Make sure you get your waters ready. Make sure you get your Holy Communion 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 ready. Somebody begin to type healing Jesus. Somebody begin to type my 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 healing Jesus. Jesus my healer. Jesus my deliverer. Jesus my promoter. Jesus my guidance. Jesus my provider. Jesus my counselor. Jesus my healing portion. Jesus my healing medication. Jesus my overdose healer. Jesus my greatest physician. Jesus the giver of life. Jesus the giver of health. My healing Jesus. My healing Jesus. Somebody call 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 healing Jesus. Somebody say healing Jesus. Somebody shout healing Jesus. Somebody shout healing Jesus. Somebody shout healing Jesus. Somebody shout healing Jesus. Somebody say healing Jesus. Makalabranda yalika baba sekete makushata libra gayanda. Ah, somebody just say healing Jesus. As much as you can call healing Jesus, just call him. Ah, just shout healing Jesus. Ah, say Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I need you to heal me today. I need you to touch me today. Ah, do not pass me by today. Do not pass me by Jesus. Do not pass me by Jesus. I have no other God beside you. I have no other one beside you. I have no helper. I have no friend. I have no parents. I have no money to go for IVF. I see you right now. As you are listening to me, the doctors have told you the only way you can have a baby is through IVF. You don't have this money for IVF because IVF is very expensive. I see you under the sound of my voice. You have done IVF. It has failed you. Right now, you cannot look up to man because men have failed you. Right now, you cannot look up to medication because medication has disappointed you. You cannot look up to nobody. Thank God that there is a balm in Gilead. Thank God for the balm in Gilead. Thank God for the balm in Gilead. Oh, my brother, my sister, your only option is the blood of Jesus. Your only option is the body of Jesus because medically they have failed you. Medications are not working for you. Even when you take that medication, you can no longer sleep. Even when you take that medication, you can no longer function. Your insurance has written off because you can no longer care for it. You were taking all that insurance because you were not able to work. You have been taking these medications. The medications are not working for you again because they have tampered with your body. You cannot sleep at night. The sleeping medication is no longer working for you. This is your last bus stop. Your tubes are blocked. You have taken multivitamins. You have taken all the vitamins you know. You have taken the Bico. You have taken the folic acid. You have taken double X. But yet, there is no solution. Today, I came to announce to you that if you can call the name Jesus. If you can call my healing Jesus. If you can call my healing Jesus. Jesus, my healer. 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 Jesus, my makalabra dayali kababa sekete makusha tadi bragayanda. Reka liba baya kelebo seke makula na yaya. Makala branda ya lika baba sekete makusha tali braka yanda ya. Hida maseke. Rama. La kalamba ya yanda ya. Lika baba sekete. Maka yanda la libo boya. Rika baba yende de. Makusha tali kaba yanda ya. Lika baba dada da baseke. Makute te lika banda ya. Heke baba lika banda ya. In the mighty name of Jesus, you have cried, you have found solution. You have gone to places, you have done things. You have consulted people, you have drunk what you're not supposed to drink. Yet to no solution, yet to no avail, yet to no redemption, yet to no changes, yet to no results, yet to no evidence, yet to no proof. But you keep on drinking because you do not know that there is a power that is in the name of Jesus. Today, I want you to call my healing Jesus. If you're in this service, shout my healing Jesus 7 times. If you're in this service, just begin to type healing Jesus 7 times. Healing Jesus. 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 Makalabranda yalika baba sekete. I see the angels standing, but these angels are not moving. I see the angels standing, but they are not doing anything. I want you to call the healing Jesus. I want you to touch the hearts of the angels. I want you to touch the Holy Spirit right now to begin to walk on your behalf, to begin to plead on your behalf, to begin to intercede for you. Because without the Holy Spirit is an intercessory. Without the Holy Spirit, nobody is going to intercede for you. Holy Spirit, my intercessor. Holy Spirit, my intercessor. Holy Spirit, my intercessory. Holy Spirit, my intercessory. Holy Spirit, my intercessory. Begin to intercede for your children. Legions of angels, makalabrandaya. Begin to feel the atmosphere. Begin to walk in the atmosphere. Begin to walk in the atmosphere. Begin to walk in the atmosphere. Instant healing. Instant healing. Upliftment. Breakthrough. Financial settlement. Marital settlement. Promotion settlement. Job settlement. Document settlement. Health settlement. Finances settlement. Contract settlement. Business settlement. In the name of Jesus. Ministry settlement. Promotion settlement. Upliftment settlement. Breakthrough settlement. In the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody join me as we shout the healing Jesus 21 times. Join me as we shout the healing Jesus 21 times. 1, 2, and go. Healing Jesus. 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 Makala branda yalika baba sekete makusha tali braga yanda. Rika baba sekete libra yanda yaya. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost so strong. I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit so strong. Father, we thank you because you are here right now in our midst. I feel you so strong. Father, I thank you because you have come by yourself. Father, I thank you because we have moved heaven for you to be here with us. Father, thank you for coming down by yourself. Father, you cannot come down for no reason. You say, whenever I call upon you, you will hear me and you will answer us. Because you have decided to come down by yourself. Father, we say thank you for honoring us. Thank you for hearing our cry. Thank you for that you have not put a broken and a contrite spirit into shame. Thank you, Lord, for being in our midst, because we know that our lives and our stories are going to change. Father, we feel your presence so strong. Father, we feel your power so strong. Saturate the whole atmosphere with your anointing. Saturate the whole atmosphere with your healing power. Saturate the whole atmosphere with your presence and let your children see you. Father, for us many that are sick in this heaven, holy communion and healing service, Father, let healing be our portion. In any area that we are sick, Lord, physically, socially, and otherwise, may we be healed from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. Father, begin to take preeminence. Father, begin to take control. Father, begin to take charge in every area of our lives. Father, move face by face. Father, move name by name. Father, move home by homes. Father, for us many that were here to save you and lifted you up, the time for you to honor them is now. Father, do same for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Many of us are standing in gap for our family, our loved ones. Father, distance is not a barrier in the realm of the spirit. So long as we are here, Father, you say, whatsoever you do for one, you do it for all. When you touch a life, you have touched the rest. Father, because you are here and you are going to touch us at the point of our need, Father, may there be no exemption. Father, do not omit anybody's name. Father, do not omit anybody's name. Though our sin be as dark as scarlet, Father, let your mercy speak for us. Cleanse us, Lord, and make us holy and acceptable. Let your healing portion locate us from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. Wherever we are right now, Lord, we cover ourselves with your blood. We take charge over the charges of the enemies. We take dominance over the kingdom of darkness. We take authority over the works of darkness. We take operation right now, Lord, and we bind them under your feet, and we say they cannot operate. We say they cease to operate right now, Father. As we release the fire, the sword, and the thunder of the Holy Ghost, Father, let your healing portion, let it be upon us like a dove on the shoulder. Let it come upon us just like it was in the days of the Pentecost. Father, the time has come for you to heal us. Father, as we drink, this is no longer what we bought from the store. This is now the blood of Jesus. The blood that was shedded on the cross of Calvary for a time like this. The blood that was shedded on the cross of Calvary for a day like this. Father, as we drink your blood, let your blood redeem and heal us. Let your blood redeem and heal us. In the mighty name of Jesus. This is not the flesh of the Lord. You say, they that eat will never be hungry. And they that drink will thirst no more. Right now, I raise it up to heaven and I give you thanks. And I say, Lord, thank you for making it possible for us to be here in this communion service. Father, we are doing this in remembrance of you like you did with your disciple. Let it not be in vain, Lord, but let it benefit results of healing. Let it turn down evidence of healings in our midst. Let it heal us of every infirmity, viruses, sicknesses, whatever was broken, let it be mended in the name of Jesus. For those that have no peace, let the blood and the body of Christ bring you peace, love, happiness, fulfillment, longevity, let it be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity again. We know that you're going to do even more than we have requested, because we have requested through Jesus Christ our Lord. Today we consecrate the Holy Communion in the name of God the Father. We consecrate the Holy Communion in the name of God the Son. We consecrate the Holy Communion in the name of God the Holy Spirit. As the Holy Communion gets into us, this is now the body of Christ. This is now the blood of Jesus. As it gets into us, let there be a new beginning. Let there be healing. Let there be instant healing. Let there be a turnaround in our lives. Now to the hour of our Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bless your Holy Communion in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I prophesy healing upon you. Instant healing. As you eat the blood of Jesus, your life will never remain the same. Take it by fire. Take it in the name of Jesus. Receive it right now. Take it right now. Take it right now. Every broken tubes in you begin to arise. Every evil fibroid, I command you to be deactivated forever. Whatsoever was locked, as you eat, it shall be unlocked. that since menstrual cycle, you shall begin to have an heavy flow. You shall flush out your system. The blood of Jesus shall flush out whatever is not of God. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost into the Holy Communion. Eat and be healed. Eat and be free. Eat and marry. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. You can eat the Holy Communion. You are a powerful healer. Come and heal, so powerful, so powerful today. Come and heal, so powerful, so powerful today. Powerful healer. You are a powerful healer. Come and heal, so powerful, so powerful today. You will heal so powerful, so powerful today. My name is Yah. Oh, your name is Yahweh. You are a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. I call you Yahweh. You are a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. 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 You are a miracle working God. Hey, Yahweh, you are a miracle working God, your name is Yahweh. Right now, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost into your waters. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost into your waters. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost into your water. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost. Somebody begin to release fire. Somebody 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 release fire. Father, in the name of Jesus, this is no longer water that was from the store, but this is now the blood of Jesus. This is now the blood of Jesus. This is now the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. I release the flaming fire of the Holy Ghost into this water. This is no longer water. Liquid fire, 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 liquid fire. Makala branga ya lika baba sekete makusha tali braga yanda ya ya. Lika baba sekete makusha tali braga yanda ya. Lika baba sekete lika baba sheteria. Liquid fire in the name of Jesus. This is no longer water but the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. As you drink the liquid fire, let it burn down whatsoever is not of God in you. Liquid fire of the Holy Ghost. Liquid fire of God the Father. Liquid fire of God the Son. Liquid fire in the name of Jesus. You may drink your water in the mighty name of Jesus. You may drink your water in the mighty name of Jesus. You may drink your waters in the mighty name of Jesus. You may drink in the name of Jesus. I don't want you to drink this with the bottle. I want you to put it in a glass. Remember while I explained that to you, right? You should always drink with a glass. So if you don't have a glass by you, that is fine. But when you are going to drink it outside the broadcast, when I am not seated in front of you, it is always good for you to use glass. Because when you buy it from the store with these bottles, you don't know what they did with the bottles. You don't know where they took the bottles. You don't know what covenant the people have. So it is always good. My God, my God. Somebody says, Mommy, I just drank my water and I am shaking already under the anointing. My Lord, my Lord. Drink and let me see your encounters. Drink in the name of God the Father. Drink in the name of God the Son. Liquid fire. Burn down whatsoever is not of God in them. In the name of Jesus. My God, my God, my God. Begin to put in your encounters. Mommy, I was having headache. My headache is constantly gone. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Okay, so if I find the person that I'm looking for, I'm going to call you on the camera. More of you. Come on, somebody just say you want more of the Lord. Come on, let me see, let me see, let me see. Begin to put your encounters, begin to put your encounters. Get up and shake your body. Use the liquid fire to wash your face. Put it into your ears. Put it into your ears. You are believing God for the fruit of the womb. Please use it and rub on your forehead. Mommy, I was having headache. It is just gone. Betty, I bless it in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I seal it that your healing is permanent in Jesus' name. Please make sure you're putting your encounters. Let me seal it up for you. I want you to get up and do what you were not able to do. Move around, jump up, touch that breast. I saw you that was having pain in your breast. I saw pain on your breast. Every time you keep touching your breast, it felt like a lump, but it wasn't a lump. I want you to take this water, apply it, and feel it again. It is gone. Just rub it and feel it again. It is gone. You were having chest pain. Begin to feel that chest and see. Go up and come down. Begin to jump. Use those legs and do it. And see that you are instantly healed. Do you know the good aspect of this service today? Because God came by himself. God came by himself. When I was calling healing Jesus 21 times, God came by himself. When I was calling healing Jesus, it came by himself. Begin to tell God, thank you. Let me see your encounters. Let me see your encounters. Let me see your encounters. A lady here, there was a certain lady here. I don't know whether she lost. You guys remember, I don't know why the people in the U.S. are so ungrateful. So I have another testimony to give, another one. There was a lady in the U.S. Mommy, I was having headache, but during the prayer service, my headache is gone. Okay, I will leave that story for another day. Let me concentrate on those that are ill and pray for them. God bless you. Please, let me see your encounters. Roslyn said, I was having pain. Now I am free of that pain. Roslyn, you are constantly and permanently healed in the name of Jesus. I want to see your encounters. Please, whatsoever you were not able to do, get up and go and do it. For those of you having problems, I drank the water and I'm feeling well right now. Glory to Jesus. Please make sure you're putting in your encounters. Make sure you're putting in your encounters. If I seal your encounters, the Bible says affliction will not arise the second time. Mommy, I have goosebumps all over my body. That is the gift of the Holy Spirit right there. I release the Holy Spirit. Remember, I said I am releasing the Holy Spirit. I am releasing the angels to come to wherever you are. Mommy, I am feeling free. I don't know what you mean by I am feeling free. Please make sure that you get up and begin to check yourself. Check yourself, check yourself, check yourself. Somebody, before the beginning of this service, you were very sad. But when I called the blood of Jesus, I saw joy coming upon you. I saw joy coming upon you. And I know that God is going to give you joy by the end of this service. Mommy, you were calling Jesus and I felt asleep for a few minutes. My God, that was God working on you right there. That was God working on you right there. Somebody says, yes, I feel so much joy. It is permanent in the name of Jesus. Somebody fell asleep immediately. You know, so many times I have been on the live broadcast. and the sleep of the Holy Ghost just came on me so strong. And all of a sudden, you see me do this. And as soon as I close my eyes, I go to a place that the Lord wants me to be, and something else happens. So it is very, very okay. That is an encounter. I was feeling very heavy, what I feel like. It is permanent in the name of Jesus. It is permanent in the name of Jesus. It is permanent. I was feeling very, very free after drinking the water. It is done. And somebody else says, my heart was so heavy, but after drinking the water, I felt peace. After drinking the Holy Communion, my mom is breathing properly. My mom was not breathing properly, but after that, Doris, can you give me the name of your mother? Father, I connect Doris' mother right now into the book of extra love. Whatsoever affliction it is that we're fighting, Father, today may it be ended in the name of Jesus. So, Doris, I see the book of Ezekiel chapter 27 verses 1 for your mother. The word of the Lord came to me. The word of the Lord came to me. Doris, I just opened the book of Isaiah chapter 27, and the Lord gave me a word for your mother. And the Bible says, the word of the Lord came to me. So the word of the Lord has come to your mother. She is permanently ill in the name of Jesus. She is permanently ill in the name of Jesus. She is totally ill in the name of Jesus. And her healing is permanent in Jesus' mighty name. Stephen, my son, I hope you're getting down all the testimonies. Mommy, I'm the one. I was sad, but I am happy now. May your happiness be permanent in the name of Jesus. May your happiness be permanent in the name of Jesus. I just saw a message. May the Lord bless our sister. Come on, everybody on this broadcast, say, God bless Sister Patience. Everybody begin to type, God bless Sister Patience. Everybody on this broadcast begin to type, God bless Brother Luciano. Everybody on this broadcast begin to type, God bless Sister Patience. Everybody begin to type, God bless Brother Luciano. Let me tell you something. You might not be a dedicated Christian, but when you love God, this is all that matters. Your love for God is what matters, not how you go to church. You need to love the Lord thy God with all your heart. Some of you are in church, but you do not love God. Some people, they don't go to church, but they love God more than you that is in church. Why am I saying God should bless Sister Patience? Because I saw a message came into my phone. And Sister Patience says, woman of God, I am really happy that you need things for the less privileged. I am giving you a bag full with children clothes and children's toy for you to use to do the work of God. This is from Sister Patience. Why am I saying that God should bless Brother Luciano? Because the phone that you are seeing me use right now on this broadcast, Brother Luciano has donated his phone right from the first day that he bought this phone. He has never used it. We have been using it on this broadcast. This is the phone that was sent to me. It is nothing. It has not even been opened. This is the phone that was given to me. It has never been opened. It has never been used. We have been using this brother Luciano's phone because the camera is heaven on earth. The camera is just massive. The bigger the phone, the better the thing that we are doing. So if you want, give God a phone in this ministry. Give God a big phone like this so that we can use it. Because sometimes we cannot use the computer when we are outside. Especially as I'm going to Africa right now. May the Lord bless Brother Luciano. May the Lord bless Sister Patience. May the Lord bless Brother Luciano. May the Lord bless Sister Patience. You need to do something for God for them to bless your name. God bless Sister Sarah. Because Sister Sarah on her own was the one that even donated the phone before anybody else donated. She gave money that was enough to buy a phone. May the Lord bless Sister Sarah in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless all the sisters. May the Lord bless all the brothers. May the Lord bless all the titles. May the Lord bless all those donating. May the Lord bless all those supporting. In the mighty name of Jesus, as we go to visit the less privileged, if your womb was locked, your womb shall be open. If they say you will not carry a baby, you will carry your baby. If they say you will not give birth, you will give birth to a baby. Make sure that you connect to the mountain program where I was carrying the a twin baby. Make sure if you are a stingy person, you have never given in this ministry before, you have never sown a seed, you have never done anything, all you say is that you don't have, but you are eating every day. Go and borrow from your generation. Sow a seed in the life of those children. Don't allow the devil from your husband's side or your wife's side to use you. You don't have, you don't have. When you go down 6 feet to the ground, you will have. You will have. When you go down 6 feet to the ground, you will have. Learn to give. You don't give when you have. You give when you don't have. That is the one that moves God. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Not they that sow in joy. No. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Read your Bible. Practice the word of the Lord. And your life shall never remain the same. My God, so many testimonies. Woman of God, I drank the water. You won't believe that I am vomiting right now. Glory to Jesus. You are totally healed. You are permanently healed. Your healing is permanent. In the name of Jesus, I also had an encounter. As I drank the water, I begin to sweat so much. As I drank the water, I am sweating from the inside. I feel like removing my clothes because I am sweating too much. When I came on the live broadcast, I was feeling a bit cold. That was why I was able to wear this. But right now, I am sweating. Thank you, Jesus, for my healing. Thank you, Jesus, for taking away cold. Thank you, Jesus, for this heat. Thank you, Jesus, for the sweat. May your name be highly exalted. In the name of Jesus, if you have been blessed, can I see you? I bless your offerings. I bless your tithes. I bless your donations. I bless your everything. May the Lord bless you. May God bless Sister Maggie Singley. She has posted something to New Jersey. Just the postal fee alone. The postal fee alone. The postal fee alone to New Jersey. The postal fee alone. The postal fee alone to New Jersey is $228. Everything that she bought for the less privileged, for her to ship it to New Jersey, is $228. I am not talking about to Nigeria. This is just to New Jersey. $228. That is what she spent to ship. I am not saying what she bought. The day she was buying the things, I was on the phone with her in the store. And she was buying them. May the Lord bless her. May the Lord increase her. May the Lord uphold her. May the Lord keep her in long health and prosperity. It is good to work for God. Don't just sit down and watch. Don't just come here and say, pray for me. Begin to do what other people are doing, and you will see the reward of the Lord come upon you sparingly. Nobody can stop. Nobody can stop the blessings of God in your life. But if you just sit down and say, whatever they like, let them down. Now we are donating money for the car, for church. Make sure that you be a part of it. So that as people are being driven for crusades, as people are being taken to and fro services, God will bless you. Begin to tell the Lord, thank you. Begin to tell the Lord, Father, bless me. Me, right now, I am trying to save money in Africa. I am sending small money in Africa for my vacation because I don't want to hope on anybody. I don't want to trust on anybody. The Bible says, vain is a man that puts his trust on another man. When you put your hope on people, they will disappoint you. Learn to put your hope on yourself and God in heaven, because human beings are not to be trusted. Human beings are not to be trusted at all. When people know that you need them, that is when they will fix appointments. They say, woman of God, when exactly do you need me? You say, oh, I'll be needing you next week. Before next week, they will tell you, oh, I have a funeral. Oh, I have a wedding. Oh, my boyfriend is coming. Oh, my children are sick. Oh, we have a church program. They will make sure they disappoint you. But when you put your hope in God, when you put your hope in God, you will not be disgraced. People will promise you heaven and earth. But when it is time to give you, they will disappoint you. Why? Because they want to disgrace you. Learn to put your hope in God, and you will not be disgraced, and you will not be ridiculed, and you will not be mocked, and you will not be teased. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord uphold you. May the Lord give you a testimony. May the Lord make you to laugh. May the Lord release your contract. May the Lord release your businesses in the name of Jesus. You will not sow for another person to reap. You will not die untimely. You will not get into trouble. You will not be found unwanting. They will not tease you or mock you. They will not say, look at what a prayer person is out there doing. The Lord will make his face to shine for you. I bless you in the name of God the Father. I bless you in the name of God the Son. And I bless you in the name of God the Holy Ghost. May the blessings of the Lord, may the goodness of the Lord, may the joy and the love of the Lord that passes all understanding, may it be upon you now till the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Somebody just say thank you, Jesus. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. Appreciate God for what he has done. I love you so very much. I don't know if you were blessed, but for me, I was highly blessed. I don't know if you were blessed, but I was highly blessed. I am highly favored. I am operating in the supernatural because God has done awesomely well for me. God bless you that has been following the page. God bless you that has been commenting on the pictures. God bless you that has been sharing the post. God bless you that is playing along with us. God bless you that subscribed to YouTube channel. God bless you that is doing everything that you can to promote kingdom advancement. As you promote the kingdom advancement, may the Lord promote you. As you work for God, may God work for you. As you lift up Jesus, may Jesus lift up your name. In the name of Jesus, you will not cry. You will not weep. You will not die before your time. You will not get into trouble. Mommy, please, next service. Mommy, remember me next service, please. No problem, Michael. I really want to see you. I really want to speak to you, but the network is really bad. So don't worry. On the next service, we shall be looking at you. We shall be seeing you. We shall be talking with you. I needed to do 3 deliverances, but the network did not allow any of those deliverances to connect. Maybe God has his way already. For those of you that your files were open, make sure you follow through promptly. Make sure you do everything. FaceTimers, you're very welcome in our midst. In Heaven Chapel, we love you. We don't condemn you. This is a ministry where we love all people to Jesus. Loving you to Jesus is our mission. And we will continue to love you till the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. I will be coming up very soon with our relationship programs. Stay connected and keep being expectant. I know it's going to come anytime soon. I have been busy with my moving, so I might not really be able to do a lot right now. I don't know when I will see you again, but I will see you. God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. I love you with the love of God. I love you. I love you. I love you. Remember that heaven is real. And my greatest wish above all wishes for you is heaven at last. I wish you heaven at last until I come your way again. Remain ever blessed. From me to you is have a lovely time out there. Be kind to one another. Be true to people. Be honest. Stay rapturable. And love one another as Christ loves you. Take care and shalom.